Water sustains life on Earth and places Earth above other planets. The valley of Kashmir abounds in huge water reservoirs like the Dal Lake in the heart of the Srinagar city, Asia's largest freshwater lake, Wular, in the north of Kashmir Valley, and River Jhelum, which flows across the valley from the south to the north. These water bodies form the backbone of Kashmir's economy. A large proportion of the population is dependent on these water bodies in one or the other way. In addition to melting snow on mountains and forests, the major source of water of these water bodies are the big and small springs scattered all over the valley. The Kashmir Valley is full of springs. It is said that there are more than 100 springs in the valley. Around 25 of them are well known, and some of them are famous as tourist spots. Verinag, situated at the foot of the Banihal Pass, is one of them. Originally in the form of an irregular, shapeless pond, Verinag was polished into an octagonal tank with sculptured stone rounded by the Mughal Emperor Jahangir. The Mughals were always fascinated by the springs and the scenic beauty of the valley. The basin of the spring, according to an engraving on a stone affixed to the basin, was constructed by Emperor Jahangir in early 17th century. Seven years later, Jahangir's son Shahjahan laid out a garden in front of the spring and constructed cascades and aqueducts in straight lines through and around this garden. Verinag is the fountainhead of River Jhelum. Another major source of Jhelum is the Kokar Nag. Kokar in the local language means cock, and Nag the spring. The place gets its name from five springs that resemble the shape of a cock's feet. The water here is said to quench both hunger and thirst, besides being a remedy for indigestion. On the adjacent sides of the canal through which the waters of these springs flow is a beautiful garden. Chashmashahi, or the royal spring in Srinagar, is renowned for its pure sweet water. It is said that once upon a time all the rich citizens of Srinagar used to procure water from this spring. Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan built a pavilion on this spring and laid out a little Persian garden with fountains and waterfalls in terraces lifted high above each other. The other springs, though equally important and charming, did not get much of the royal attention. They could not therefore achieve the name and fame like that of the Chashm-e-Shahi. Springs in local parlance are known as Nag, which literally means serpent. The Hindu manuscripts and mythology give reference to the Kashmir Valley as the land of water inhabited and ruled by Nagas.
Millions of years ago, Rishi Munis felt the need of a place like heaven on earth for humans. In search of the same, Kashyap Rishi reached Kashmir.
कश्यप ऋषि जी पृथ्वी का भ्रमण करते 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 जो है कश्मीर घाटी में पहुंचे उस
देन इट वॉज फुल ऑफ वॉटर एंड वॉज नोन एज सतीसर थ्रू मेडिटेशन कश्यप ऋषि एलिमिनेटेड द रूलिंग नागास
विष्णु महेश की आराधना करके यहाँ जो नागों का राज्य था उसको खत्म किया
ही सक्सीडेड इन ड्रेनिंग वॉटर आउट ऑफ द माउंटेन्स एट बारामुल्ला
पहाड़ को वहां से निकाला तो इसका पानी को निकालना
Springs are held in reverence even today. Their significance is not restricted to any particular religion, but to all denominations and sometimes that too simultaneously. Anantnag, meaning the place of countless springs. One of them lies in the vicinity of the shrine of a Sufi saint, Baba Haider Rishi. Devotees to this shrine do not forget to have a few sips from the spring water. Some even carry it home. Apart from being a place of religious importance, this spring of Marthand is famous for the huge number of fish. These fish, considered sacred, are fed by the temple authorities. Kashmir Valley is also known as the land of saints. Many of these saints would stay in the vicinity of the springs.
The spring in the vicinity of this shrine is known as Machnag. It was originally a small streamlet in which the saint added a few drops of honey to make it grow bigger in size. A wooden plank is lying there deep in the waters for 700 long years without being harmed. A sheer miracle indeed.
These springs also act as symbols for communal harmony. This is Sirnu, once a Hindu-dominated village in District Pulwama in South Kashmir. The village is famous for a spring known as Mongnag. Devan kan do bachna chasan chod The springs even today act as a catalyst for promotion of communal harmony among the Hindus and the Muslims.
We come here for worship. Muslims also come here for ablution and prayers. I come here at 3 in the morning and 7 in the evening.
Apart from having religious significance, the water of this spring is also used by the villagers for their everyday needs. The inner spring of Anantnag, known as Andarnag, has a temple, a gurdwara, and a mosque around it, a manifestation of Kashmiriyat, a mosaic of Hindu, Sikh, and Muslim coexistence. In addition to the purity of water, some springs are also known to maintain a constant temperature throughout the year. For the whole year, the water of the Marthan Nag maintains a temperature of about 9 degrees Celsius. Malak Nag, another spring in the Anantnag town, maintains a temperature of around 20 degrees Celsius. It has a rich content of sulfur. Locals say the water helps in getting rid of various skin diseases like rashes and face acne because of its sulfur content. There are numerous sulfur springs in the valley, and many of them are in the Anantnag district.
I am Muhammad Abdullah Bichu from Anantnag. There are a number of springs. This spring contains sulfur, which cures skin rashes.
The water of these springs is of great importance for the people of Kashmir. They utilize it in many different ways. Springs have been helping Kashmir's tourism and economy. But now it is the turn of the people of Kashmir to pay these springs back in equal terms. They need to get a bit responsible towards nature, or else these springs may soon be confined to books and documentaries. The water bodies will dry up and the land may lose its beauty for which it is known the world over. Water sustains life on earth and places earth above other planets. The valley of Kashmir abounds in huge water reservoirs like the Dal Lake in the heart of the Srinagar city. Asia's largest freshwater lake, Wular, in the north of Kashmir Valley, and River Jhelum, which flows across the valley from the south to the north. Bodies form the backbone of Kashmir's economy. A large proportion of the population is dependent on these water bodies in one or the other way. In addition to melting snow on mountains and forests, the major source of water of these water bodies are the big and small springs scattered all over the valley. The Kashmir Valley is full of springs. It is said that there are more than 100 springs in the valley. Around 25 of them are well known, and some of them are famous as tourist spots. Verinag, situated at the foot of the Banihal Pass, is one of them. Originally in the form of an irregular, shapeless pond, Verinag was polished into an octagonal tank with sculptured stone rounded by the Mughal Emperor Jahangir. The Mughals were always fascinated by the springs and the scenic beauty of the valley. The basin of the spring, according to an engraving on a stone affixed to the basin, was constructed by Emperor Jahangir in early 17th century. Seven years later, Jahangir's son Shahjahan laid out a garden in front of the spring and constructed cascades and aqueducts in straight lines through and around this garden. Verinag is the fountainhead of River Jhelum. Another major source of Jhelum is the Kokar Nag. Kokar in the local language means cock, and Nag the supreme. The place gets its name from five springs that resemble the shape of a cock's feet. The water here is said to quench both hunger and thirst, besides being a remedy for indigestion. On the adjacent sides of the canal through which the waters of these springs flow is a beautiful garden. Chashm-e-Shahi, or the royal spring in Srinagar, is renowned for its pure, sweet water. It is said that once upon a time, all the rich citizens of Srinagar used to procure water from this spring. Mughal Emperor Shahjahan built a pavilion on this spring and laid out a little Persian garden with fountains and waterfalls in terraces lifted high above each other. The other springs, though equally important and charming, did not get much of the royal attention. They could not therefore achieve the name and fame like that of the Chashm-e-Shahi. Springs in local parlance are known as Nag, which literally means serpent. The Hindu manuscripts and mythology give reference to the Kashmir Valley as the land of water inhabited and ruled by Nagas.
लाखों साल पहले जो है सभी ऋषि मुनि महात्मा और सभी देवता स्वर्ग में बैठे थे उस समय कश्यप
Millions of years ago rishi munis felt the need of a place like heaven on earth for humans in search of the same kashyap rishi reached kashmir
kashyap rishi ji prithvi ka bhraman karte 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 jo hai kashmir ghati mein pahunche us
then it was full of water and was known as satisa through meditation kashyap rishi eliminated the ruling nagas
brahma vishnu mahesh ki aradhana karke यहाँ जो नागों का राज्य था उसको खत्म किया
He succeeded in draining water out of the mountains at Baramulla.
बारामुल्ला में पहाड़ को वहां से निकाला तो इसको निकालना आरंभ हुआ
Springs are held in reverence even today. Their significance is not restricted to any particular religion, but to all denominations and sometimes that too simultaneously.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
Anantnag, meaning the place of countless springs. One of them lies in the vicinity of the shrine of a Sufi saint, Baba Haider Rishi. Devotees to this shrine do not forget to have a few sips from the spring water. Some even carry it home. Apart from being a place of religious importance, This spring of Markham is famous for the huge number of fish. These fish, considered sacred, are fed by the temple authorities. Kashmir Valley is also known as the land of saints. Many of these saints would stay in the vicinity of the springs.
The spring in the vicinity of this shrine is known as Machnag. It was originally a small streamlet in which the saint added a few drops of honey to make it grow bigger in size. A wooden plant is lying there deep in the waters for 700 long years. Without being harmed, a sheer miracle indeed.
Itcha karamata, yitis vaktas yi rozun maujood aithanas, magar yishu avliyai kiraman hus, yish Allah Taala hante man yi azmat bakhishmus, itcha karamata.
These springs also act as symbols for communal harmony. This is Sirnu, once a Hindu-dominated village in district Pulwama in South Kashmir. The village is famous for a spring known as Mongnag. The springs even today act as a catalyst for promotion of communal harmony among the Hindus and the Muslims.
We come here for worship. Muslims also come here for ablution and prayers. I come here at 3 in the morning and 7 in the evening.
Apart from having religious significance, the water of this spring is also used by the villagers for their everyday needs. The inner spring of Anantnag, known as Andarnag, has a temple, a gurdwara and a mosque around it, a manifestation of Kashmiriyat, a mosaic of Hindu, Sikh and Muslim coexistence. In addition to the purity of water, some springs are also known to maintain a constant temperature throughout the year. For the whole year, the water of the Marthan Nag maintains a temperature of about 9 degrees Celsius. Malaknag, another spring in the Anantnag town, maintains a temperature of around 20 degrees Celsius. It has a rich content of sulfur. Locals say the water helps in getting rid of various skin diseases like rashes and face acne because of its sulfur content. There are numerous sulfur springs in the valley and many of them are in the Anantnag district.
I am Muhammad Abdullah Bichu from Anantnag. There are a number of springs. This spring contains sulfur, which cures skin rashes.
The water of these springs is of great importance for the people of Kashmir. They utilize it in many different ways. Springs have been helping Kashmir's tourism and economy. But now it is the turn of the people of Kashmir to pay these springs back in equal terms. They need to get a bit responsible towards nature, or else these springs may soon be confined to books and documentaries. The water bodies will dry up and the land may lose its beauty for which it is known the world over.